Although we've discussed the reinforcement design tab sheet quite a bit already in our course, we're going to take an even closer look at how this tab sheet works. We can interactively design the reinforcement of a cross section for simple and compound bending, shear force, and torsion. If the cross section is subjected to several types of forces, the program will proceed to do the following. First, it will design the longitudinal reinforcement for simple or compound bending. In other words, with or without axial force. It will then determine the additional longitudinal reinforcement due to the presence of shear force, which we'll discuss a bit later on. And finally, it will provide transverse reinforcement and give information on stirrup reinforcement where relevant. The result of the design affects the reinforcement that has been introduced. In other words, the reinforcement that we input geometrically is adjusted. So we must be careful if we simply want to carry out a verification without affecting our reinforcement. If we want to execute reinforcement design for multiple combinations, which must always be factored, FAGUS will perform design step by step. In this example, it would design for combination 1 and obtain the reinforcement. This reinforcement will be the starting point to design for combination 2, and so on. The reinforcement design tab sheet, as we can observe, is quite simple, with relatively few options. We merely have to define, first off, which variant we want to design, if there is more than one. And skipping over to this third button, we can modify the list of preferred diameters, meaning the diameters we want the program to use when determining reinforcements, both for longitudinal reinforcement as well as for stirrups, which will allow us to keep the program from proposing unrealistic values of reinforcement like 80 bars of 8, instead of more realistic values like 9 bars of 25. This is how we can limit the different diameters the program will use, logically limiting design options to the reinforcement we have access to at our construction site. Finally, the Design button. Here we should emphasize that we will always be inputting design forces, and hence these forces must always be factored. If the forces come from static, they will logically be the result of an envelope, with its factored coefficients, while if we're inputting forces obtained through other programs, we have to be sure they are factored.